Kelly Ann Conway. This may be a girl.
Yes, come on, Kelly Ann.
The presidency is about choices, so I'm curious why President Trump chose yesterday to send out his press secretary to essentially litigate a provable falsehood when it comes to a small and petty thing like inaugural crowd size. I guess my question to you is, why do that?
Chuck, the president did many things yesterday and the day before that are very meaningful to America. He signed executive orders to stop Obamacare and all of its problems. Many people have lost their, millions of people have lost their insurance, their doctors, their plans. So that stops right now. He's going to replace it with something much more free market and patient-centric in nature. And on this matter of crowd size, well, for me, I think the most quantifiable points of interest for Americans should be what just happened a few months ago that brought him here. I don't think ultimately presidents are judged by crowd sizes at their inauguration. I think they're judged by their accomplishments.
You make a very reasonable and rational case for how crowd sizes don't matter. Then explain, you did not answer the question. Why did the president send out his press secretary, who's not just the spokesperson for Donald Trump, he also serves as the spokesperson for all of America at times. He speaks for all of the country at times. Why put him out there for the very first time in front of that podium to utter a provable falsehood on this on day one?
Don't be so overly dramatic about it, Chuck. You're saying it's a falsehood, and they're giving Sean Spicer, our press secretary, gave alternative facts to that.
Zeke Miller, 4 of the 5 facts he uttered were just not true. Look, alternative facts are not facts. They're falsehoods. It's a small thing, but the first time he confronts the public, it's a falsehood?
Chuck, Chuck, I mean, if we're going to keep referring to our press secretary in those types of terms, I think that we're going to have to rethink our relationship here. I want to have a great open relationship with our press.
I want to go back to a question that you continue to deflect. Why was it necessary to send out the press secretary on his first day in office to utter a provable falsehood that now calls into question everything the press secretary of state will say from here on out? It
no,
will
it
for many Americans.
No, it doesn't. You want them to hear that. You want them to hear that I'm not answering your questions, which I'm doing. You want them to hear that they can't trust our press secretary. I think that
what
is a very dangerous statement.
Is
not to call things ridiculous that are said by our press secretary and our president. That's not your job. You're supposed to be a news person. You're not a news person.
If you do this, you have not answered it.
That's answer it this way. I'll answer it this way. Think about what you just said to your viewers. That's why we feel compelled to go out and clear the air and put
so
alternative facts out there.
It's a political tactic to come up with alternative facts and try to set up the press as your enemy?
No, I didn't say that at all. And that's not why I'm here. In this building, I'm here because
I don't fuck with you.
Any permanent statements you'd like to make?
No, I'm done talking to the press. Get out of here.
Oh my God. Somebody has to follow that. And we picked just the right person for it too.